next, thank you so much. The next review we have is from Navnath Pawar. He's coming up with the Bombay Balchao, and I think it is best I'm going to give it to him to give the introduction of the author and also obviously the review of the book. Over to you, Navnath ji, please.
Thank you, Radhika ma'am. Good evening, everyone. So today I'm going to review a book called Bombay Balchao. Okay. So Bombay Balchao is a first novel by Jane Borges. So she's a columnist at Sunday Midday. She writes on heritage, culture, books. And previously she was also working, she worked on a project, Mafia Gang of Mumbai. Mafia Queens of Mumbai, stories of women from the gangland with S. Hussain Zaidi. She worked with S. Hussain Zaidi on that book project. And Bombay Balchao is her first novel. And this is a Bombay novel, means it is for anyone who loves Bombay, or now it is called as Mumbai. So Bombay's history, communities, the native people, their fashion, their music, and most prominently food, which is described in this book. So Balchao, that what he's saying, B-A-L-C-H-A-O, Balchao, or they call it a Balichao. So it's a spicy, tangy Goan dish. It is cooked with meat or prawn. So it is also considered as a pickle. So it's a tangy pickle. So this novel sets in Christian localities in Mumbai on Dilima Road. And it sets in one building called Bosco Mansion. So this novel has 12 stories revolving around this Dilima Street in Mumbai and about this building called Bosco Mansion and the people there. So this building is a home to Goan, Mangalorean, and the local Christian communities who call themselves East Indians. So the span of this novel is from 1945 to 2010. So, and the protagonist of this book is Michael Coutinho. So there are these 12 stories wherein he's there and the people from Bosco Mansion are there. But these stories are not in the linear fashion. So we get the story from 1945, then we get a story from 2010 in between to 1972. So these stories are not in a linear fashion. They are from the various stages of this protagonist, from his childhood, from his adulthood, and right from his old age. So these various characters are there from this building. So the story starts with a character, Michael, and who is recalling an eventful day from his 70 years ago. And on the same day, he witnessed one miracle which will be remembered for years to come. And he lost his childhood love, Tracy, into that. And the next chapter introduces us new characters into that, like his sister is there, like Annette Coutinho. Then the following chapters introduce like various characters like Mario Lawrence, and how he become after a breakup, he became this crossword king. He spent his life with solving these crosswords in the newspapers. And the another important characters in this novel are Michael's wife, Marilyn, and Elena Gomez. So Michael's unexpected one-sided lover, who is Elena Gomez. And he was not aware that it's a one-sided love till in the old age only, when his wife died, he comes to know that she also loves him. So these characters are connected through love and friendship and through sharing the same building or the same locality. And they're simple living, and there are some incidents which are very simple incident, but it takes very eventful turn in the end. So these are very warm characters, and the writing style of this author is very simple And once you can just pick this book, you will not put down after finishing it. So why I like it more, because this Christian community is not portrayed much in this English literature. There are very few examples, like this Jerry Pinto, who has written the M.N. Big Home, and this very other communities in India, they have portrayed well in the novel, but this Christian community is not portrayed so far in this fashion. And one of the interesting thing about this book is about the story. They have described the Christian food in that, like right from the sorpotel to this peas, and then this ladi pav. So they have covered all this food, and even the Christian weddings, and they have covered the canvas from 1945 to 2010. So if you are from Mumbai, then you can familiar with all these streets from the South Bombay and all these places. So it's very nostalgic for me to read this book. So I went back to South Bombay and all these places there. And this is a very interesting chapter wherein that Elena, she prepares this Bombay Balchao. And it's feel like a reading a poetry, and the art of preparing this tangy prawn pickle is strewn with the life lessons in that chapter. So rest other chapters are very filled with comedy, and so there are very simple incidents also, but it leads to the laughter on all these chapters of this novel. So I recommend these books to anyone who just want to have a good time and spend around 4 to 5 hours of their life reading this light reading novel.
Okay. Thank you. So let's open the forum for discussions. I hope you've concluded, Navnathji. This is okay. Sure. Forum is open for questions. Please unmute yourselves, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Sorry.
Hi. Is it a collection of stories or is this a novel?
It's a novel, but these are very different stories are there at different stages of the protagonist's life, Michael.
Okay, nice. I've heard some interesting names during the review and I'm intrigued. I will probably read the book sometime in future. Thank you.
And it's also it's also coming up with, you know, any movie or any web series kind of. So recently that author had revealed that the movie or any web series production rights have been transferred. So we'll be able to see any web series.
Okay. You mentioned something about Jerry Pinto, right?
Yes.
I read his book and that was a really very nice book I have come across in recent contemporary Indian writing. So
yes.
What were you telling?
Jerry Pinto, I have read his two books. So one is M.N. Big Home and second one is Murder in Mahim. So he covers this Bombay and their Bombay, Mumbai and its culture. And M.N. Big Home, I think he has covered this family. He has portrayed the family wherein that mother has this suicidal tendency.
I know. Yes. I read that M and the Big Home, but then not the other one.
Yes.
Okay. So Murder in Mahim. Guy also.
Yes. And Murder in Mahim is also about that this what you can say LGBT issue, and it sets on this plot of this serial killer who kills only this LGBT people. And Jane Borges also portrayed this only Christian community and how their lifestyle and their day-to-day life is covered into this.
Is this Anglo-Indian community or?
They call them as East Indians, but they are Goans and Mangaloreans.
Okay.
Mangalore.
Okay, yeah. the Goans are a different kind of people, yes, in India.
Yeah, and here in this language, you will see many Konkani words are also involved into.
Okay,
Konkani,
nice.
Hindi, Marathi, these words are also there in the narratives.
Oh, reading the title, I thought it is something like a protest kind of thing, because Narmada Balchao is a very famous thing.
And I thought it is something. It's Balchao, or it's called as Balchao.
Balchao, okay, nice.
Oh, that's how it is pronounced.
Thank you.
Balchao. So even I asked Google what is the correct pronunciation of this Balchao, Balichao.
No, that's fine. I mean, she's referring about the pickle that you have mentioned.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So that is Thanks, Kirti. That is in sync with some incidents of her life. That particular pickle, the way it is made and all that is, I think, a very core part of the culture in that Mumbai area.
It is about how these different people, they shape their destinies are interwoven into each other.
Okay. Right.
It's not particular about that recipe, but we have good references into this novel.
Absolutely. I mean, it is like they are trying to draw something while they do that to the story and the storyline.
Yes.
Yeah, that's very true. Yeah, I think this is her first novel.
Yes, it is her first novel.
Yeah, okay. Interesting. Any others who'd like to interact on this?
Yeah, wonderful review, Navnath.
Thank you, sir.
And especially I envy, because book review with background of a library.
True.
Yeah, I'm in the office now.
Yeah. This is your house, right?
No,
your office. I'm sorry.
The library.
No wonder. Okay, but I still remember in your house also you have similar things. So I got a little confused. Good. Thank you so much, Navnathji.
Welcome.
So if we are done with other questions and all, should we go ahead with the third review? Okay.